There's a company in Wales people are talking about. It's brought a smile to thousands of faces. Now it's the name on everyone's lips. Just Rentals. Just ask Neil.
Neil Jenkins yn gallu ffyrwni'r clenhawn a throsi o'r ysbys.
Neil Jenkins is one of those players who doesn't come around very often. For a start, he scored over 1,000 points, which is ridiculous. It was quite heartwarming to meet someone you think is so special in what they do, yet is so humble a person and so easy to talk to and get on with. So yeah, that was quite an eye-opener for me and something I've really tried to learn from.
The greatest goal kicker that Wales has definitely seen on world rugby has ever seen.
He's a people's man, people can relate to him. He's a great guy and a real hero. You know, what Neil represents is all what's good about the Welsh, the Hiraeth, you know, the people in Wales.
That's all you ever want to do is, you know, pull that red shirt on, because I believe you me, the feeling you get when you run out in a national stadium is something you can't ever explain.
The Lions played out in South Africa in 97. I mean, Neil was the cornerstone of that success, I believe, with his goal kicking. Playing out of position.
South Africa were scoring tries but couldn't kick the conversions, were missing their penalties. Every time they sort of gave away a penalty, Martin Johnson would call up Neil, come here Neil, bang, 3 points. Bang, 3 points. And the crowd hated Neil Jenkins, the South African crowd, that ginger monster, this, that and the other. And he kicked the Lions to victory, simple as that.
Almost from halfway, it's a long way out. But Neil Jenkins has caught it quite beautifully. What a kick! Jenkins. Second successful kick for him, and Neil Jenkins has done it. He's reached his 1,000 points, the first player in the history of the rugby union game to score 1,000 points in test match rugby. Proud man, and every one in the stadium is willing this ball to go straight and true for Jenkins. Neil Jenkins. No one gives us a hope at the end of the day, no one gives us a chance. England, very good side.
Wembley wasn't our greatest place. I didn't like Wembley, to be honest with you, but we had to travel all those miles up there. And I remember going into the game, and we were very quiet, the Welsh, that day, because England were going for the Grand Slam. And I can remember they were selling England Grand Slam T-shirts before the game, and I thought, oh, God.
Only got three forwards in the line-out, and it'd been left to Chris Wyatt, and how well he did that again. Scott Quinnell, a bust by Scott Gibbs. Scott Gibbs is through. Scott Gibbs has scored. What an amazing try. Scott Gibbs' sixth try for Wales in his
30th. He's putting his arm up. I said, get around here. Get around under the post. Well, get as close as you possibly can, because I knew we were still behind.
And of course, as soon as we crossed the line, and it was just no question, and then I tossed the ball to Neil and said, just kick the thing, and I was put a nail in this game.
That's what he said to me, those exact words. Not blinking thing, effing thing. He said, just kick the effing thing, he said. I said, oh, thanks, mate. No pressure.
Graham Henry is impressed, but he's not showing any emotion because he knows that Neil Jenkins has got to kick the goal to put Wales into the lead.
Who would you want to kick this in World Rugby? That man.
Of all the great goals he's kicked in his life, Neil Jenkins, this will lift the roof. Has he stuck it over? And indeed he has.
He has won, or kept, Wales in so many games that, you know, you can't start to, you know, to add them up, and because his kicking was so good, you know, they could hang on in there. If they were in the opposition half, they had a penalty, invariably he would knock it over. And I think I've seen some great kickers, you know, Grant Fox was one of the best, then I've seen Lainer, Johnny Wilkinson,
Domingo Ayres, Gavin Hastings.
I've never ever seen a better goal kicker than Neil Jenkins.
He kicked in sides that weren't successful, so maybe if you've been playing for, let's say, a present English side, like Johnny Wilkinson's getting six chances at conversions. You know, Neil perhaps was only having one or two conversions because we weren't successful. So I think, you know, the way he conducted himself each time, the same routine, the same concentration, head down, follow through, magnificent technique, and, you know, he's rescued Wales on so many occasions that I think under those circumstances, I would rate him as the greatest goal kicker of all time.
Makes no mistake!
In his own words, he was a boy from a working class background who ended up becoming the most capped player for Wales and the biggest point scorer in the history of international rugby. As he says himself, he can't believe it, but the fact he's done it is an inspiration to all, and he's somebody whose name will always be synonymous with Welsh rugby.
Can I have a sausage and chips, please, for Georgia? Yeah. And just a bag of chips for myself.
They are my pants, my lucky pants. And they were once Kevin Morgan's before the France game, but I forgot my pants, so Kev gave them to me, and they haven't been taken off ever since. For any match, anyway. I only wear them in rugby matches.